Hi everyone. Thank you for joining me. My name is Nghĩa. I'm a research scientist from the AWS AI Lab of Amazon. Today, I represent our collaborative research team to talk about our latest work on active distillation machine to leverage pre-trained black box model in private data setting. This is joint work with my colleague from Peking University IQVIA, National University of Singapore, and UIUC. For this presentation, I will start first with a key motivation underlying our work. This is drew from a black box healthcare scenario, and I will identify in particular a set of practical challenges, and I will discuss our proposed solution to these challenges. And at the end, I will show how those contributions can be tied together under a single active distillation machine framework, which is our key contribution. And towards its end, I will also summarize and present our key theoretical and empirical evaluation of the proposed framework to demonstrate its efficiency. So for now, without further ado, let me start with the following motivation. Here we are interested in a black box health analytics scenario where leveraging and customizing pre-trained black box model for transparent predictive analysis in local data context has become increasingly important for local institutions where they do not have sufficient data for training and or where they do not have the necessary computation capability to build their own predictive local model. In such scenario, it is a common practice for a provider to train a private model using their proprietary data and release the trained model as a black box service. For example, the IQVIA Human Data Science Cloud provides such machine learning service. However, from the perspective of a local institution, one concern of using such pre-trained service is that there is no transparency regarding its prediction, and this prevents local institutions from understanding and inspecting whether its reasoning mechanism has accounted appropriately for potential bias in their local training data. And this is important because depending on such assessment, further customization of the pre-trained model might be necessary to customize better towards the local context. So this is the first challenge, rationalizability of black box prediction. And also related to the challenge is the issue of lacking visibility into the cloud model. And this arguably aggravates the difficulty of addressing the first challenge. In fact, these two challenges go hand in hand. All right. And then there's the third challenge of query complexity, where the problem is that for local institutions to use the service, it needs to upload the private data to the service provider's cloud. And this could increase both the risk of leaking sensitive information and the cost of protecting them from cyber attack. And as such, we might want to minimize the query traffic to the cloud by, for example, selecting only the most informative query given the past observation. So to address all of these challenges, we are proposing an active distillation machine. And the diagram of this machine is shown on the left. On the right, I summarize the key feature and the desiderator of the distillation framework. Basically, at the top, the ultimate goal of this framework is to translate an arbitrary AI model into an interpretable surrogate representation. The key feature of this framework will be an active strategy for knowledge distillation and an interpretable representation that can be used by the domain expert to extract population representation and individual representation on the healthcare context. For example, the population explanation will inform directly the relevant symptoms for each disease, whereas the individual explanation will generate an influence score for each relevant symptom. And in the remaining of this talk, I will talk about the solution to each of these challenges, starting with the distillation of black box knowledge. For this part, we will first describe the input-output of our system. Here, each local institution will send a patient profile to the cloud model as an input. And the input is basically a multi-hot vector indexed by the medical code that comprises the patient's medical profile. And the output here is a set of predictive score, one per disease. And we assume that they are NDC. For each disease, there are two outcomes, positive and negative. And so for each disease, there are two probability scores summing up to one. And based on those return probability score, our model needs to learn a surrogate model that preserves the predictive performance of the black box while adopting a representation that can be interpreted well by the domain expert. One extra assumption that we impose here on the black box is that it factorizes across the different disease model. So for our surrogate model, we will also factorize across the disease model. So in what is going on next, I will just describe the parameterization of a single component. This single component is parameterized by a triplet of three components, a vector that characterizes whereas a particular factor would be relevant to a disease or not. This is a column taken out of a global matrix. The row of the matrix correspond to the symptom, and the column correspond to the disease. So here, if we're talking about component I of the surrogate model, then we are only using the I column of the global explanation matrix. And we refer to BI as the global rationale for DCI. And it details which factors are relevant to the disease on the population level. And in addition to BI, we have a local scoring function that map from the input to an m-dimensional scoring vector, one per factor, right? So this basically tells us in extra that given the profile of this patient, whether this relevant factor will strongly influence the condition of the patient based on this disease context, all right? And all this information can be combined together linearly using a set of linear coefficient alpha, which can be learned based on the output that will return from the black box model. So to learn this representation, we are matching its response function with the inverse logic of the black box feedback. And this essentially boils down to a quadratic minimization task under a constraint that the sparsity of the global rationale is upper bounded by a predefined threshold. And this threshold is customized by the domain expert, characterizing the cognitive limit of interpretability. Intuitively, if the global explanation vector is too dense, then it would be hard to pick out the most important symptom factor that characterize the disease. So from the perspective of a domain expert, there should be an upper bound on the relevant factor. And that is up to the domain expert to indicate. All right. So this is basically our mechanism for distilling black box knowledge into a local representation. In the next part of the presentation, I will now talk about the active distillation problem. In this problem, we are trying to address the following question. Given the past observation, which data point should we query next? Intuitively, we need to look at those that will likely incur a disagreement between the surrogate and the black box. But how do we know that the output of the black box and the surrogate will be in disagreement without actually sending in the query? So one idea is to use past observation to learn a disagreement region. And the disagreement region here is defined to be the set of data point, input point to be precise, such that the corresponding predictive outcome produced by the local representation model and the cloud model will be highly divergent, meaning that their callback library divergence will be above a certain tolerance threshold, which can be set algorithmically to guarantee agreement with high probability. And in a nutshell, from the past observation, we already know the probability return for this past observation by the cloud model. And we can use our current estimation of the surrogate model to compute the outcome probability again. And then we can compute their divergence. And because of that, we can determine whether the input of the observation will fall into the disagreement region or not. So this will be the training data set for us to learn the binary classifier. Once learned, this binary classifier can be used on unseen input to determine whether the input will fall into the disagreement region or not. If it does, then we can just sample from the disagreement region to send in a query. All right. And in the next part of the presentation, I will highlight several key results saying that if we want to upper bound the probability of disagreement between the surrogate and the cloud model by a certain function, depending on the distillation error and the robustness of the black box model, then we need to incur a number of sample query in the worst case. For passive distillation, the worst case complexity would be proportional to 1 over gamma power 4, where gamma, as I mentioned briefly just now, is the prediction robustness of the black box model, which I define formally here. Now, on the other hand, our theoretical analysis shown that for active distillation, the required query complexity is actually much fewer than the required complexity in the passive distillation setting. So this confirmed our intuition earlier that active distillation make better use of data, because in the end, to guarantee the same upper bound on the disagreement probability, active distillation is shown to require fewer query in the worst case. So this is our key result showcasing the efficiency of the active distillation. Now, in the rest of this presentation, I will also evaluate our proposed framework on a practical healthcare dataset. This is the MIMIC 3 dataset, and we are comparing the performance of our active and passive version on a variety of disease signal. All right. And across all of these experiments, one thing that can be seen very clearly is that on the same budget allowance, the active version mostly outperformed the passive version by a significant margin. And again, this corroborates with our theoretical observation earlier that active distillation make better use of sample information than passive distillation. And finally, we present our case study, which highlights the interpretability of the local scoring explanation in conjunction with the global explanation of the disease. So here we pick out 100 patients, and for each patient, we represent the patient by a scoring function, a scoring vector over 20 medical code, and we generate the corresponding heat map on the right, on the left. And on the right, we are projecting the scoring vector of the patient on a lower embedding space using Disney. And we can see that the project vector from this entangled cluster, we effectively cluster the patient into different subtypes. And this information is particularly useful because when we have an incoming patient and we know that the projection of this patient belong to one of the existing cluster, then as I mentioned previously at the beginning of this presentation, we can have the opportunity to reuse the treatment plan that we designed for patient of this subtype for the new patient without putting the new patient through a lengthy diagnosis process. And that will save a lot of labor costs. So this is the end of my presentation, and I would just like to summarize the key message in the following. We are proposing a new black box distillation framework which can extract knowledge from a black box model. And our active distillation component has provable guarantee on the query complexity, and the empirical evaluation on a reward data set show very promising result. This is the end of my presentation. Thank you for joining me in this session.